if the phrase "the negative pressure of dark energy" is not clear to you, if you're finding weird the existence of invisible, non-interacting matter, which is 5 times more than ordinary matter, and you think that everything can be explained with logic and common sense, then you should watch this video until the end. Have you ever wondered why curved space is curved in different ways? That is to say, for matter, it is strongly curved. And even the moon, when moving in curved space, eventually gets back to the initial position. But the rays of light, when moving nearby the Earth, change its direction slightly. But how is it curved? Can you even imagine it? It's obvious that the deviation angle in this curved space depends on the speed of the body. But then, is it even a curvature of space? Curved space should equally deflect all objects moving in it. But if it's not curved space, then what is it? This is a moving of space. And this curved space accelerates as it approaches an object, like the flow of perfect fluid. And this acceleration has inverse square dependence on distance. And finally, we can understand the essence of the law written hundreds of years ago. And the gravitational constant finally gets a clear physical meaning. And the reason of time dilation in gravitational field becomes obvious. But how does the acceleration of space create the force? Like the force that pushes you back into your seat when your car accelerates. The same force that pulls you off your seat when you brake hard. This is the force of inertia. And the same force appears when the space around the body accelerates. And that's why gravity is equivalent to inertia. And gravitational mass equals to inertial mass. Scientists have known about this equivalence for a long time. But there wasn't theoretical basis to prove it. And this can only be proved in the case of a moving of space. But here it's not about the change of speed with respect to time. But every infinite small point of gravitational field has a speed gradient, has an acceleration, which creates gravity force. And to each body that has mass, space moves proportional to this mass. Space moves to each particle of matter, but there's no accumulation of space in it. It supposedly transforms and responsible for existence of electric charge. And as it known from experiments of annihilation of electron-positron pairs, released energy equals to sum of mass of electron and positron. But electric field energy is not released. It can be seen from this experiment that mass and electric charge are links in the same chain. Besides, due to the particles of matter having extremely small size, which are tens of thousands of times smaller than atoms, the speed of space in close proximity to them, in a very small time interval, increases by millions of times and creates such a gravitational force that the gravity becomes a nuclear force. This movement of space originates from the universe expansion. The space of universe expands so uniformly that even photons while moving through it elongate uniformly. And this is the reason of cosmological redshift. Due to the uniform nature of the space expansion and due to the fact its movement is always directed towards the closest particle of matter, the maximum speed and the acceleration of space are close to massive matter accumulations. Therefore, on the scale of the solar system, we observe this as the attraction of the planets and the sun to each other. But on the scale of the universe, we observe it as a repulsion of the galaxy clusters from each other. That is to say, in the scale of universe, we observe it as a dark energy. The same motion of space in massive galaxies partially or completely neutralizes the reason of appearance of centrifugal force. And because of this, the motion of stars and galaxies doesn't obey the laws of Kepler. But the consideration of motion of space gives such prediction of motion of stars, which corresponds completely with our observations. Because of this motion of space, we miscalculate the speed of galaxies in galaxy clusters, because the double Doppler effect takes place. And this mismatches of our observations with theoretical predictions forced us to assume the existence of dark matter. Also, this local motion of space in the solar system gives a significant contribution in the anisotropy of CMB and other radiation. And maybe because of this, it seems us that the whole huge region of the universe moves in a common direction and at very high speed. This motion of space also alters our understanding of supermassive black holes, explains the reason of quasar jets, and solves the problem of cosmological coincidence. And if on the scale of the solar system, the speed of space is low enough, and we can ignore it, explaining everything by the curving of space, we will occasionally encounter anomalies which we won't be able to explain. But on the scale of the universe, we will have to use dark energy and dark matter. And who knows how much more hypotheses we will need to invent to cover up all the inconsistencies in the general picture of cosmology.